And Seth is from Illinois, so this is one of the few out-of-staters in this group. Nice to see when Illinois does come on over to Michigan sometimes. I know if any of you guys ever follow the Midwest scene at all, there's a lot of, I guess, loving gripe between Michigan and Illinois on how Illinois rarely ever travels over to us outside of Big House season. But that's beyond the point. They're all here now, and that's all we can ask for. So let's getting into this game number one. Now, you see Seth versus Lovin, Diddy Kong versus Yoshi.
Now, if I remember correctly, general consensus on this matchup is that it is one of Yoshi's hardest.
Yep, and that's 100% based on Diddy Kong's fair.
Yep.
The shutdown.
Because Yoshi always likes being in the air, and Diddy Kong's fair is, like, in contention for best anti-air in the game.
Yeah.
Like, it's insane, the risk-reward on that move.
Yeah.
It's very, very skewed, and so it really gives Yoshi a hard time.
Oh, and he jumped into it, and Lovin, he's shaking his head. He knows that he goofed us a little bit there. And Seth, this is a very common matchup for him. We know that both Seth and JJ Rockets do play a decent amount over at all the Chicago tournaments, whether it's an Ignite Weekly or a Poplar Creek Bowl. Oh, that's a footstool! Oh,
yeah, but between the two eggs, even if that one didn't make it back up, I'm pretty sure the second egg would have.
Whenever I see Yoshi gets footstool, I'm like, oh, they must be like shaking in their boots. Most Yoshis remember the days of Brawl when recovery was just barely an
option.
Oh
yeah, the egg didn't really move you upward.
You were just a sitting duck for footstools there. Oh, Seth got him in an offstage position. What's he going to do? Just lets him get back on.
I was kind of expecting like a runoff nair there. But
I thought he was going to be... Oh, no! Lovin!
He caught on to that roll habit real quick.
Lovin. One of those... It's like... That's what happens with lower-level players. They get into those panic option moments.
Yeah.
And they just start rolling. And Seth called him out and got it. So we're moving on to game two.
And it is a pretty common option to see players try to, like, when they panic, they try to roll towards center stage because that's where stage control is. That's where they want to be. But
yep. And more importantly, you're not as close to the blast zone.
Yeah. But that's what players often look for.
Yeah.
You know, so it's very it's like a double-edged sword,
yeah.
Basically.
It's they want to get to that comfort zone, and sometimes that comfort zone is not enough. And Seth, just like Meat Beef, we're just seeing him really love these Yoshi fairs. Mm-hmm. I think it's just like an unspoken thing amongst Yoshi mains that they just love utilizing fair. It is one of Yoshi's kind of like safest poke options, I guess, just because you can drift away and you can drift in. And it does a decent amount of shield stun. So you get trapped in your shield when you're trying to play defensive versus it.
Mm-hmm. And if you, as long as you space it properly, I'm pretty sure it's mostly safe on shield.
Yeah.
Just in terms of like how far away he is. Oh my god!
Wow. He did a glide toss into up smash.
That's Diddy's thing. You can't do him like that.
Well, E2C Zone Seth just did that, and Lovin is just really looking like he's getting his book read pretty hard right here.
He caught Lovin on the platform with that dare and picked up the banana at the same time.
Broken.
He knows this matchup so well.
He has to. Like, when you live, when you're in a region with a top level Diddy Kong, like somewhat of JJ Rocket's caliber, you kind of are forced to learn the matchup.
Yeah, especially since, like, JJ goes to so many
tournaments. Oh no, and Lovin was hit out of the barrels. And E2C Seth advances 2-0. That's two victories for Yoshis on stream today. Something you don't see much, folks.
It was just like the last pool I casted. There were so many Sonic sets in a row.
Oh, is that the Lou Rich and True Blue pool?
Every set.